Good day, everyone. Good day, panelists. We are the Group 3A from BSN 3A. I am Maria Kim Gupalor, and together with me are my groupmates, Kayla Gonzaga, Prince Gonzalez, Michaela Guerrero, Dinan Hardinel, and Rafaela Jimenea. And we're here to present to you our research study entitled The Coping Mechanisms of Nursing Students with Virtual Learning.
Virtual learning has become one of the main apprehensions in the Philippines. By definition, it is the acquisition of information through various online platforms. The proposed Advanced Nursing Education Act of 2020 expands the importance of experiential learning in nursing, which includes immersions in the community. However, due to the heightening cases of COVID-19 in the country, related learning experiences of nursing students are conducted online. Because of this, several factors contribute to the queries of how nursing students are able to cope with the current educational system. Through this study, different self-developed coping mechanisms will be determined and how they are effective in relation to students' educational responsibilities while there is an ongoing pandemic.
For the statement of the problem, this study aimed to determine the coping mechanisms of nursing students to virtual learning in University of St. La Salle for a semester of academic year 2020-2021. Specifically, it answered the following questions. Number one, what is the demographic profile of the nursing students in terms of age, sex, and year level? Number two, what are the coping mechanisms of nursing students to virtual learning? And number three, is there a significant difference in the coping mechanisms of students when they are grouped according to age, sex, and year level?
For the significance of the study, so the findings of the study may benefit the following members of the society. First is the College of Nursing Administration. Second is the clinical instructors. Third is the nursing students. Fourth are the parents or guardians. And last are the future researchers.
For the hypothesis statement, there is no significant difference in the coping mechanism of nursing students when they are grouped according to age, sex, and year level.
For the theoretical and conceptual framework, basing on the Roy adaptation model by Sister Calista Roy, we first acquired the demographic profile of the Salian nursing students, such as their age, sex, and year level. After that, we obtained their coping mechanisms, which are the following: positive reappraisal, confrontative, distancing, self-controlling, social support, accepting responsibility, escape avoidance, and planful problem solving. With the data gathered, we were able to determine the coping mechanisms of the Salian nursing students to virtual learning.
For the research design, the study followed a quantitative approach, and under that is a descriptive study. A questionnaire was prepared to Google Forms and was sent privately to the social media accounts of the students.
For the participants of the study, we have the LaSalle nursing students coming from all levels. And with the use of Rao Soft sample size calculator, the result was 255 being the sample size. Certified random sampling was used. In this case, groupings were differentiated according to the population per year level. So we have here level 1 with 100 participants, level 2 with 94, and level 3 with 61, a total of 255 participants.
For the research instrument, the questionnaire was composed of researcher-made questions. Likert scale was used in the second part of the questionnaire, specifically in determining the coping mechanisms of nursing students with virtual learning. Gooden Scales was the chosen validity tool, and considering the scores given by the juries, a mean validity score of 3.5 was obtained, which is interpreted as very good. Subsequently, the group 20 students who were unable to partake in the study to be subjected to a reliability testing using Cranbox Alpha. The group obtained a score of 0.7, indicating an acceptable level.
For the data gathering procedure, the first step the researchers did was to write a letter for the approval to conduct the study at the University of St. La Salle through the College of Nursing. Then, the researchers made the survey questionnaire for the intended participants through Google Forms. After the survey questionnaire was approved, the researchers distributed it to the level 1 to 3 Thessalian nursing students. Participants had given enough time to respond, and after that, the researchers reviewed their responses. Then, the gathered data were tallied and computed. The researchers also made use of secondary resources together with the primary data to support the results. And for the statistical treatment, the responses to the survey questionnaire were sorted, organized, processed, and tabulated with the use of Microsoft Excel and SPSS software tools. For objectives 1 and 2, descriptive statistics like frequency, distribution, and percentage were used. For objective 3, inferential statistics like t-test and one-way ANOVA were used.
For the ethical consideration, so the researchers that conducted the study adhered to the following. So first, the researchers respected and followed the rules of the institution during the conduction of a survey on its students. Second, participants were informed of the purpose of the research and signed the consent form signifying their agreement to participate. And lastly, concerning data storage, gather data was used only for the research and not another means.
For the results and discussion, figure 1 shows the demographic profile of the participants. In terms of age, 22 years old and above had the lowest percentage in population with 5.5%, followed by age group 18 to 19 with 39.6%, and the highest percentage is age group 20 to 21, having 54.9% of the population. This implies that the majority of undergraduates aged 20 to 21 years old are studying in the course of BSN. In terms of sex, we have 76.1% of female LaSalle nursing students, which implies that the female population was predominant in the survey. With regard to year level, level 1 had the highest percentage of the population, having 39.2%, followed by level 2 with 36.9%, and lastly with level 3 being the lowest among the three levels, having 23.9%.
For our figure 2, the coping mechanisms of nursing students with virtual learning, according to our results, accepting responsibility was the most utilized coping mechanism, followed by planful problem solving. The least used coping mechanism was escape avoidance.
For table number 3, as reflected in the table, there was no significant difference on the coping mechanisms of nursing students in terms of sex. This is because all of the items below have a p-value greater than 0.05, which indicates no significant difference.
For figure 4, in the significant difference in the coping mechanism in terms of age, the highly used coping mechanism for ages 18 to 19 and 20 to 21 is accepting responsibility, while for ages 22 and above is planful problem solving. So the table shows that there is a significant difference in planful problem solving in terms of age, while other coping mechanisms have no significant difference.
Figure 5 refers to the significant difference in students in terms of year level. Accepting responsibility was the highly used coping mechanism of nursing students in levels 1, 2, and 3. Both levels 2 and 3 had the lowest mean score in distancing, signifying that it is the least used coping mechanism. Meanwhile, escape avoidance was the lowest scoring coping mechanism in level 1. That was that the result of escape avoidance indicates a significant difference in the least used coping mechanism in terms of year.
In conclusion, the nursing students from the University of St. LaSalle were found to manage stress more effectively basing on the evidence from the findings. Accepting responsibility and planful problem solving were the most used coping mechanism, while escape avoidance was the least used. The significant difference manifested in the coping mechanism of nursing students in terms of year level shows that escape avoidance was the least used coping mechanism in level 1, while distancing was the least used in level 3.
As a recommendation, the researchers recommend to take the study as a guide for future researchers to continue to improve its results. So here are the following recommendations. First is to educate and support the students. Next is to increase the number of the participants. Next is to widen the scope of the study. And lastly, is to increase the time allowance. This is in order to acquire the much needed data for the study and to provide a better and significant result.
For the utilization, the results of the study were submitted to address the coping mechanisms used by level 1 to 3 nursing students and to offer them a less stressful experience in virtual learning. Also, it was handed over to the College of Nursing at University of St. LaSalle to update and improve the interaction between teachers, clinical instructors, and students, by which students can be helped to remain productive and optimistic with their studies.
So here are our references. And for the acknowledgments, the group wishes to extend our heartfelt gratitude to the following: Almighty God, Dr. Sheila Trajera, Ms. Leslie Young, the participants of the study, the researchers' loving parents, and most especially to the panelists. We couldn't have done this without your guidance. That is all for our presentation. Thank you for your time and for listening.